Having provisioned, launched and set sail all on the same day, we were a little late leaving harbour. It's now mid-afternoon, and this shall have consequences for the latter part of the journey. Determined to try to sail all the way, we allow events to unfold as they may. This single-handed sailing is a tricky business. The wind died. We'll not make port before dark. Damn the torpedoes. Warning, not to be used for navigation. This green buoy is the Most Landing Harbour recommended track buoy. As its name would suggest, it marks the track vessels should take when approaching the harbour entrance. Vessels are not expected to take this so literally as to nearly hit it. At night, this buoy is unlit. This object, the size of a small car, could present a major obstacle to navigation. To the unwary mariner, that is. Moss Landing is a curious mix of commercial vessels, liverboards, derelicts, and derelict liverboards. The water is not exactly clean, and the boat slips are referred to as holes by certain persons in positions of authority. However, the place does retain a certain charm and authenticity. If you like that sort of thing. There are several surprisingly good restaurants here, as well as antique stores, curio shops, etc.
You made up about this.
It's perhaps not for the typical marina set, and most will pass it by. Go placidly amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. Here we have a nice example of a squid boat. Let's take a brief foray into the local environs. The power station is driven by natural gas and dominates the skyline to the east. Designed to supply power during peak demand periods, it does not run all the time. There is a plan to phase it out and replace it with a giant on-site battery bank. This to be charged by an equally massive solar array. Here again we see the good ship Jonah. If anyone knows what this is for, do let us know in the comments. Time for some dinner.